Pierre, can you please come into my office? Thank you. Come in.
Good morning, Mr. Walter. How are you?
All right, you?
Good.
All right. I actually wanted to run a new idea by you.
Oh, that's good.
And I have a distant relative that actually gave me a proposal. And he can give me an exceptional deal on the wine. And this is the product. And
wow, they look very fancy.
Yeah, and you know, with this, I would like to take this opportunity actually to create a gift giving program to our loyal customers, which one may have. You
know, it sounds very interesting.
Yeah, I actually really like the idea too. And I was wondering if you can just send a memo to our sales department and run by them to see what they think, and if they do like it, to see how many bottles each rep would actually need.
Okay, yeah, I understand. I will get you the result as soon as possible.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
You've got mail.
Come in.
Good morning, Marius.
Pierre, how are you?
Very good. Congratulations to your new position.
Thank you very much.
That's the file that you're asking for.
Oh, that was put. Thanks. A few manages here. I like. I might have to take a look.
How are you today?
Afterwards. I'm very good. I'm just trying to see how things work here.
That's good.
I like it. But I have a few comments. I have a question, basically.
Oh, it's my pleasure to ask you a question.
Thank you. I received this email this morning from a customer, from a big customer, and I'm going to have to read the email out loud to you. It says, "Dear Mr. Panagi, I thank you and your company for the greeting you sent us for Christmas. We also wish you a prosperous new business year. We take these gifts you send to our purchasing agents as a token of your esteem. However, I must ask you to discontinue this practice in the future. Our company recently decided on new purchasing policies. These policies do not allow our purchasing agents to accept any gifts from suppliers. I'm sure you will understand our policy. I'm looking forward to a continuation of the good business relations that traditionally exist between our companies."
Oh.
And I didn't know that. I didn't know that the company's policy in the past was to send gifts to customers. What kind of gifts have you been giving out to customers?
Well, it was the idea of the former sales manager, Mr. Waters' whole idea. He allowed us to send wine to our customer.
Mm.
The size of the wine is where from 3 bottles to 12 bottles according to the customer's volume. His idea is to continue to build our relationship and for many other factors.
How long have you been doing that though?
Well, we have been doing that for years. It more become our tradition and culture that allow our sales rep to send gift to our customer during Christmas.
I see. So did you receive any email in the past, or did you receive any complaint letters from customers regarding this issue?
Well, throughout the years, I didn't receive any complaint letters, and I didn't hear any sales rep receive the complaint letters as well.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It seems like things are changing now, and I don't know, as far as I understand, some companies are changing their policies.
Uh-huh.
Because the way they view it, maybe they don't see it as ethical. Maybe some people see it as bribery, and this is an excuse. I mean, maybe we lose customers because of that. And I have to see what I'm going to do, because I'm skeptical, and I think I should discontinue this gift giving. What do you think?
Well, as your personal assistant, I think that you better ask about the opinion of the sales rep, because I don't work on the field. I don't know what's going on when they sell to the clients. So when you have time, you can talk to the sales rep and ask more about the opinions, ideas, and what they feel if you're going to stop the whole concept of gift sending.
That's a good idea. I will do so soon.
So, Good luck.
You wanna show me what kind of wine?
Yeah, sure. It's on the
I saw this magazine, but I didn't know why you wrote it here for.
Well, we used to have a relationship with a wine company so we can get a discount of the wine. And I want to show you what kind of wine that we receiving and send it to our customers.
Do you remember how much it cost you last year for this
wine?
Yeah,
of course. This is the wine that we sent it to our customer. We spent $25,000 for 9,000 bottles of wine. So it maybe cost us $3 for a bottle. And then we sending from as low as $9 to $36 per customer.
$3 per bottle? Well, that's a low price for a wine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure this wine cost more than $3 though.
Yeah, because we have a good relationship with the wine company and we have been doing it for years. So that's why they give us a big discount on it.
Okay, can I keep this magazine for now?
Sure, that's yours.
Thank you very much.
Okay, if you don't have any question, I'll go out and do my work. All right?
Okay, go ahead and I will speak to you later.
All right, I'll see you later.
Okay, thanks for coming.
Okay.
I see you, Ryan. Yo, Keith, you was right. We just get started. Yeah, man.
You see, you're searching for somebody that'll take you out and do you right. Well, come here, baby, and let daddy show you what it feels like. You know all you gotta do is he'll be what you're sipping on.
Saturday morning, what are you doing here?
Well, my wife picked me out of the house yesterday, and here I am.
Oh, it happened to me sometimes in the past, but at least you can do some work, I guess.
So what are you doing here?
I'm just thinking. I figured out that the company has been giving out good French and German wine to customers, and this cost the company $25,000. Including packaging and shipping in bottles, which was 9,000 bottles, and I think this is a pretty high cost.
Yes.
And I was just a bit skeptical regarding this issue. I thought of discontinuing this practice, just changing the culture of the company, because some businesses, they don't really like this kind of policy. What do you think?
I don't think that's a great idea, sir. The process of gift giving, I think, our clients, the wine, it builds long-term relationships overall with them, and I think it overall drives sales. So, in my perspective, and if you take that tool away from us, I think it's going to have a negative effect.
Do you think that all sales reps would say the same thing if I asked them?
I think so. I mean, we enjoy giving the gifts, and our clients enjoy receiving them. And if you take that away from us, I don't think it's going to be a positive thing.
The last company I used to work with, like 10 years ago, they used to give cigars out to customers. Mm-hmm. But now I received an email like 2 days ago from a customer that they don't like us sending them gifts. So that's why I came. I'm asking you this question right now. But I appreciate your help, and I have to just see.
Well, I've never had a problem with any of my clients complaining, so that's a first to me too.
That's good to know. Go back to sleep, or maybe you can just do some work. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye.